Okay, just fired up Old Faithful here. As you know, you have to wait for that fan to die down in the back. You hear it burning out the dust. So here it is. Here's the printer. I might have to pause a few times. This is stock printer with some mods. Put it in a box. Oh, look, it got quiet. Enterprise. Okay, so here it is, the assembled printer. I use a tie to squeeze these together. It helps with the torque from the motor when it does retractions. Around the side here is where the plug for the motor actually is. So we'll undo that. What I did was I made a custom plug where I cut the cables so that I could reverse them. Anyway, here it is. So what you would do next is that I would slide this off of the back, or up first, I would say, so I can get loose. Now that that's loose, it's already pulled to size, so I just leave it connected. Next thing you have to do is that from the stock mount where the fan is on this printer, which it has to be a stock printer, very important that you, it's a maker select, which I cut and bent that metal part up. I thought the name was, there it is. See, it's gotta be one of these. In any case, as you can see, the fan is running. So what I have to do now is I have to undo these screws here. Once it feels loose, should be able to get these guys pretty much out. Normally I use two hands for this, but okay, that one's loose. Just make sure this one's out far enough. Try not to hit the fan with your fingertips. You'll just break the fan. Here's about fingertips, they go back. Then just lift this guy off of here. And it comes off as one single part. Let me pause so I can clear a spot to sit this down. Okay, so here it is. Now this duct here is not really needed, but this tab does hold this down. So it's kind of a pain, but you have to slip that in there. And then on the other side, you have to press in an M3 nut. Okay, so that's that. And what you have here is the printer gearbox. Spin it around. Get a metal plate of some kind for this design. You'll need to put a flat plate against the side, and then I also put a metal clip on top of here so that this screw doesn't bore through the plastic. That's the only reason for that. It's a really long. These are all M3 screws. I mean, hex nuts. Try to get a better focus. Here we go. Okay, so. And then this bit of tubing isn't really necessary. You can actually leave it out and just have your piece of plastic filament that's sticking out from there. It doesn't need to have that metal sheath around it. I just added it in for stiffness, but it's unnecessary. By the way, this is your stock extruder, no modifications, except for you have to take the fan that was on this side and then flip it over to this side here with all the parts necessary. It's a separate little plastic part here that reinforces that fan, otherwise the printer will break the fan frame apart, I discovered. Also, the block that came with the printer, you need to take that off, and I recommend boring a hole down to it so you can recess the nut. I used some spacers, two nuts to fix the metal tube, which you also need to